switch off their mics. I request the name, number, and email ID in the chat box. Okay, a very good morning to one and all present here and those who are connected to us through various channels from different parts of the country. I, Mayur Verma, on the behalf of DG CCS NEOM Jaipur, welcome you all to the webinar series by National Facilitators of CCS NEOM Jaipur on agriculture marketing in COVID-19 period. CCS NEOM Jaipur is being a premier institute established by Government of India to serve various agriculture-related aspects such as training, research, consultancy, and education in agriculture, fulfilling its mandate by dissemination of information and knowledge in relation to agriculture marketing during tough times like COVID-19. Now, I would like to introduce the eminent speaker of today's webinar, that is Mr. Roshan Lal Meena from ICAR, NBSS, and LUP Regional Center, Udaipur, Rajasthan. He published 9 abstract, 15 articles, 1 research papers, 2 technical extension bulletins, 1 e-publications. Now I would like to invite Mr. eminent speaker, Mr. Roshan Lal Meena, to please start the session. Please, sir, start the session.
Thank you. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible. Please continue.
Okay, respected DG sir, NEOM, faculty members, director ICAR NBSS LUP and head regional center Udaipur, all the national facilitator, dear colleagues and students, good morning to all of you. And I welcome you all in the series of webinars for the national facilitator of the CCS NEOM. Before going to the topic, I will introduce first my institute. I am working for the ICAR NBSS LUP Regional Center Udaipur, which headquarter is situated at Nagpur, which established in 1976 with the 5 regional centers, each at Nagpur, Delhi, then Udaipur, then Bangalore, then Jorhat, and Kolkata. The major work of my institute is in the field of soil survey and land use planning. The major achievements of the institutes are my institute has been developed agroecological region and sub-regions of the country and 250,000 scale map of the country throughout the states. Then so digital soil mapping of the country and developed various decision support system, mobile apps of LRI. And presently, my institute is hosting the mega project of ICRA, which is land resource inventory of the country as 1:10,000 scale. Now, coming to the topic, my topic for today's webinar is do's and don'ts for the farmers in COVID period. As we all know that this, this disease pandemic time is coincided with the harvest of Rabi season crop. And farmers are worried about their harvesting, storage, transportation, marketing of their produce, and agricultural practices to be done in the standing crop, as they are facing various problems, including unavailability of labor. So today we will discuss about the activities should be followed and activities should avoid during COVID period to get the maximum benefit to the farmer. This is regarding agricultural contribution in the country's GDP. Agriculture is sharing around 14% of GDP of the country. It was early at the time of independence, the agriculture share was 50%. But after decade, after seven decades of the independence, now contribution of agriculture is in the GDP is around 14%, which is decreased from 50% to 14%. Now other other service and industry sectors are increasing and they are significantly contributing in the GDP of the country. Despite of this decreasing in the GDP of the country of agriculture share, agriculture is sharing the 53% of the labor of the country in contrast to service class 7 to 25%, non-manufacturing 11% and manufacturing 11%. So still the agriculture is most important aspect of the country and which provide the occupation to the people. So agriculture is very important and we have to take care of our farmers during this COVID period. So general do's and do's during COVID period, we should take care of these things during COVID period to avoid and to reduce the infection of the COVID, which are wash hands with the soap and water frequently, then use an alcohol-based hand sanitizer, Then while coughing and sneezing, cover mouth and nose with the handkerchief and avoid close contact with anyone with cold, cough or flu like symptoms. And maintain safe distance of at least 1 to 2 meters from others. And avoid touching your eyes, nose, ears and mouth. And use a face mask if you have symptoms of cough, fever, difficulty in breathing. If you are carrying of a COVID-19 suspect, and if you are a health worker, if you have a job that entails public interaction. So in these cases, you have to take mask compulsory. And if you have enough fever or difficult in breathing, then you should consult to the doctor immediately. And these are the general points during COVID-19. We should always do such things during COVID period to reduce the infection of the COVID. Then these are come in close contact with someone who is displaying symptoms of coronavirus. Then shake hands, hug your friends and near ones. So we should avoid shake hands and hug of the near and dears. And go to the crowded places like park, market and religious. We should isolate ourselves to reduce the infection of this disease. And cough or sneeze, if you are cough or sneeze into your bare hands, then we should use the tissue paper or hanky for the cough and sneeze, and we should not do it in the bare hands. Then touch your eyes, face and nose. We should not touch our hands on the eyes, face and nose. Then self-medicated is also not good in this time, because this disease is sometimes it's not having any symptoms, so you have to consult with your doctor and go to hospital for routine checkup. We should avoid the routine checkup during this period. Then as far as possible, make teleconsultation with your healthcare provider and invite family members and friends at the home. So we should avoid such things to reduce the contamination of this COVID. So like this, we should wash our hands with the sanitizer, which contains more than 70% of alcohol. And we should maintain the 2 meter or 6 feet distance to reduce the contamination of this virus. So these are the do's for farmers in COVID period. The government has exempted farm operation, farm works, custom hiring centers for farm harvesters and implements, as well as mandis and procurement agencies for the lockdown. So farmer need not to worry about their produce. The government has accepted the agricultural activities for this period. So farmer can easily go to the mandi according to them, and they can sell their produce. They need not to worry this. So while doing such agricultural activities, farmers should maintain the social distancing. Then for taking any emerging issue related to managing crops, livestock and fisheries, farmers should consult and to be in touch with agricultural scientists, Krishi Vigyan Kendras, ICR's research institutes and state agricultural universities. So if farmer is having any problem and any issues, they can contact with the KVK person, ICR institutes and SAUs. They can suggest them the proper and guidelines. Then disease crisis has coincided with the harvest season of rabi food crops such as wheat, millet, pulses and oilseed and other crops. We need to take precautions as we will be engaged in the harvesting of grains, fruits and vegetables, milk, eggs and fish. So we have to take precautions to reduce the contamination of coronavirus through the social distancing and maintain some hygiene. Then similarly, proper sanitization is required for using shared or hired machinery for harvesting. Then use ICTs for agricultural information. Now COVID situation, farmers are facing problem regarding their information regarding mandi, crop prices, etc. So the farmer can use the ICTs for to get this information. They can use Kisan Suvidha app, then M Kisan app, Agri Market app, then eChopal, and mobile app. They can use many mobile apps and use ICT for getting information. Like Kisan Suvidha, this app provides the information on weather of current day and next 5 days, then dealer market price, agro advisories, plant protection, IPM practices. And this also provide unique feature of this app is extreme weather alerts and market prices of commodity. This app, extreme weather alert is there, and the market prices we can get the local area as well as throughout the country. Then M Kisan app. Through M Kisan app, we can get advisory and information being sent by the expert and the government officials throughout the country. So farmers can get the information according to their requirement from this app. Then Agri Market. This Agri Market app provides the information about the local market Sir, what the prices is going on, but how much produce is requirement? So these things we can get through this agri market app. There is another option to get price of any market and any crop in case person does not want to use GPS location. So there we can get the information about the markets of throughout the country also. Then there are a few horticultural apps, animal husbandry apps, other useful app for the farmers, and DD Kisan channel, eChopal, mobile phones. So these are the ICTs where from where the farmers can get the information about their marketing and about their produce and their prices. So they get get the information of the produce. Then don't for the farmers during COVID period. Leave on rumors regarding agricultural information, agricultural market price and others. The farmer should avoid the agricultural information rumors because nowadays the so many news are fake. So farmers should not believe on such news. They should use the information and communication technology, and they should do their practices according to that. Then nervousness. Farmers should not nervous during this period. After uplifting of lockdown, they can sell their produce. And during this period also, if they need money, they can sell their produce using these ICTs. There are so many ICTs in agriculture which can be useful for the information in agriculture, horticulture, animal husbandry, agriculture engineering, rural development, agriculture news, and many other enterprises. This is the Kisan Suvidha app. We can any farmer can register on this app, and they can get the information about weather, dealers, market price, plant protection, agro advisory, KCC, soil health card, and cold store and go downs. So farmer can get these type of information through this Kisan Suvidha app, and they can get the information about various type of cross market price also in the nearby mandi. So at the home only they can check the prices, and according to them they can plan to selling their produce. And we can also get the weather update, seller details, mandi mulya, krishi salah, and plant production. So we can get the holistic information through this app. They can have, through this farmer can get the benefit. Then Kisan Rath app. Nowadays farmer is facing problem for the transportation, but through this app they can get the easy transportation at any time, which governed by the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. So okay, Mam Kisan app or Umang app. Through this app, we can get the information about agricultural products, market price, and agro advisories. This is Agri Market app. Through this app, we can get the market price of various crops nearby and throughout the country. These are the commodities for which we can search the prices. It almost covers all the commodities regarding this information. And this is the horticulture app. Through this app, we can get information about horticultural enterprises. This is the mobile app developed by the National Bureau of Soil Survey and Land Use Planning according to their climatic condition and soil constraint. Through this mobile app, we can get the soil properties information, potential and crop constraint, suitable crops, suggested land use plan, and in particular area, we can get information about which crops are suitable for the sowing and what are the major problems of the area. So through this, we can plan the farming. Then eNAM, this is the platform for electronic national market, and here farmer can produce the sale. Around 585 regulated markets are registered on this, and more than 87.5 lakh farmers are registered on this. So this is the platform for the selling of the produce, and farmer can use this eNAM platform for the produce during this lockdown period. So they can get benefit through this, and they can get more benefit, and they can also, they can reduce the mediators and amount. So this is about the do's and don'ts during harvesting and threshing of the crops. As we all know that this COVID period is coincides with the harvesting of the rabi crops. So during practices, we should follow the social distancing. Then we should maintain personal hygiene by washing of hands with soap. Then wear of face masks, protective clothing, and cleaning of implements and machinery. Then harvesting of wheat is approaching in upper northern states through combined harvester in Himachal Lake and other and their movement between state and between states have been permitted. Although it has been harvested in many other states, precautions and safety measures of workers engaged in repair, maintenance and harvesting operations is to be ensured. Then mustard, lentil, maize and chili crops has been harvested and farmers need to do storage and marketing of these crops using this ICT technologies. Then sugarcane harvesting is at peak and is also time for manual planting in the north. So we should follow these practices for the sugarcane in the north. Then measure of personal hygiene. Everybody should take the personal hygiene at the while doing the farm activities. Then in case of manual field operations of harvesting, picking, accomplish the operation in 4-5 feet space strips assigned on the one strip of one person. The farmer should follow the social distancing during harvesting and other activities at the field and maintain safe distance of 3-4 feet during rest, taking of meals, transfer of produce at collection point and loading and unloading. So at this point of time, the farmer should take care of these things. Then stagger the field operations wherever possible and avoid engaging more number of persons on the same day. So we should avoid the activities which we can avoid easily and we should engage less laborers than normal days. And engage only familiar persons to the extent possible and after reasonable inquiry as to avoid the entry of any suspect or likely carrier during field activities. We should avoid the outsider peoples to reduce the chance of this virus. Then prefer mechanized operations over the manual wherever feasible. Only the essential number of persons should be allowed to accompany the machines. Then all machines should be sanitized at the entry point. And at regular intervals, all transport vehicles, any bags or other packing material should also be sanitized. Then the collection of the produce may be done in small heaps spaced at 3-4 feet and field level processing should be assigned to one or two persons heap to avoid crowding. Then proper sanitization and cleanliness of the threshers for harvested maize and groundnut is to be maintained, especially where machines are shared and used by the farmers group. So we should sanitize the machine where machines are used or hired from the group. So here in this picture we can say that peoples are gathering together, so we should avoid these things during farm activities and we should adopt the social distance and we should do the farm activities with maintaining the social distance. So do's and don'ts during post harvest storage and marketing of farm produce. While transport and storage, what activities we should adopt. And while performing drying, threshing, winnowing, cleaning, grading, sorting and packaging operations at the farm level, wearing of protective face masks may help against aerosols and dust particles to prevent respiratory difficulties. So we have to follow these things to avoid the infection of this coronavirus. And ensure proper drying prior to storage of harvest grains, millets, pulses at farm home, and don't reuse previous seasons jute bags to prevent pest infection. And we should treat them with 5% of neem solution to reduce the infection of this. And adequate precautions to be taken for storage of produce at the farm in jute bags that are made available in the farm or in nearby cold storages. Then adequate personal safety measures to be taken for loading and transporting of farm produces and while participating in sale at market yards and auction platforms. Next is said producer farms are permitted to transport to seed companies with a supporting document and to follow precautions while receiving payments. Then seed processing and packaging and transportation of seed from seed producing states to growing states is essential to make available seed for ensuring kharif crops like sorghum Sudan grass. Seed for green fodder for sowing in April, May in north comes from southern states. So while transporting the seed material from south to north, we should follow the precaution measures. Then precautions to be followed for direct marketing, supply of vegetables such as tomato, cauliflower, green leafy vegetables, cucumber and other forbid from farms. Then grading of agricultural outputs like food grains, dairy, vegetables and fruits, etc., according to the Directorate of Marketing and Inspection under the Ministry of Agriculture. So during this lockdown, we can grade our produce and we can get some more benefit rather than previous years. So we should do this grading according to the Directorate of Marketing and Inspection. Then value addition at farm level to get better pricing and avoid less market due to peak season. So we must farmer should must go for the better pricing grading to get the better pricing and avoiding less market prices during this COVID period. So grading and standardization is a market function which adds value to a produce as it moves along a channel. So this is about the grading. So there are three types of grading: for domestic market, for international market, and for agri marking at produce. So advantages of grading is grading facilitate good marketing, ensure a common trade language, and this grading widens the market, and grading reduces the cost of the market. Marketing and ensure higher prices and help the consumers in getting of quality of produce. So these are the benefits of grading. And grading increases pricing efficiency, and grading and standardization have now assumed adopt importance for modern instrument of agricultural marketing. So now the grading is a passion. Everybody wants the high quality material than quantity. So farmer can do this grading at their farm level, and they can get more income through their produce. Grading according to farmers' perspective, to get easy finance when a commodity are stored, they can get easy finance on grading material. Then to get the claim settled by insurance companies, they can get the insurance on this grading material. To get a storage place for the produce, for grading material, farmer can get easily for storage. For then to get a market information as per the grade of the produce, then to pool the produce of different farmers, and to improve the keeping quality, and to participate in future spot trading. So likewise, in cart yard or tractor or truck, we can export our material with maintaining social distance. While going to the market also, we should maintain the social distance, like these pictures. And while milking also, we should maintain the social distance. This is India is having 20 climatic regions. And India is having second largest arable land, largest net irrigated area, 50% cultivated area compared to 11% of the world, then 50 major climatic and climate, then 60 out of soil, 40 out of 60 soil series, then largest livestock production, largest milk producer, second largest producer of sugarcane, second largest producer of cereals, second largest producer of fruit and vegetables, third largest producer of forest grains. And India is top 5 worldwide producers of egg, animal, meat, groundnut, coffee, oilseed, and tobacco. But the thing is that after getting so much of output from agriculture, we are losing so much of amount in the post-harvest losses. India is losing 93,000 crores of rupees every year due to post-harvest losses. And because we are having less infrastructure for that, post-harvest and grading of the material and post-harvest management, that we are not using post-harvest management in the country. There we have less infrastructure, so we have to develop the post-harvest management infrastructure in the country to reduce the reduce the loss of the money. So likewise, farmers are forced to through their farm produce because they are not getting enough and proper price to pricing for their output. So why that's why these ICTs are initiated by the government of India and farmers are using them, but still there are lot of works to be done by the government to ensure the proper and put enough prices for the farming commodity. So in dairy product we are doing only 35% of processing. Then for meat and poultry, we are doing 50% buffalo meat and 6% poultry meat. We are doing less processing compared to other Western countries. In fisheries, we are doing only 8% of processing. In fruit and vegetables, as we all know that fruits and vegetables are perishable outputs of the farmer, and we are using only 2% of fruits and vegetables for the processing. And we are due to this, we are losing 44,000 crores of money every year due to this fruits and vegetable loss. So there are a lot of activities to be done by the government and adopted by the farmers to reduce the losses of fruits and vegetables. And this is a big source of employment also. So this is a big sector to do in the future. So do's and don'ts during standing field crops. The temperature in most of the wheat growing areas is still below long-term average and likely to delay wheat harvesting by 10 to 15 days in a few areas. It's the harvesting to be done in the May, like in Himachal Pradesh and Jammu and Kashmir, harvesting of wheat to be done in the 15th of May, after 15th of May. Therefore, farmers can delay wheat harvesting till May without incurring any significant loss, which give enough time to manage logistic for procurement and announcement of the dates. So farmer can, if possible, they can extend their harvesting dates for the market stagnation. Then Rabi paddy is grain filling stage in southern states is widely affected due to neck blast incidents. Adequate precautions to be taken while spraying of recommended fungicide by contract sprayers and farmers. In case of any unseasonal rain at harvest stage in paddy, spray 5% salt solution to prevent seed germination. In for horticultural crops at the fruiting stage, such as mango, while carrying out field operations related to nutrient spray and crop protection, adequate precaution in inputs, delivery and washing of equipment is to be undertaken. In rice fallow, white fly management with proper safety measures may be taken up to prevent yellow mosaic virus incidents. So these are the another do's and don'ts for the field crops. If we have standing crop of rice, the rice crop reaches to the flowering stage, it is necessary to ensure sufficient moisture in the field and application of remaining nitrogen doses around 50 kg should be done. If second wetting is not yet done, immediately second wetting should be done. In case of borer, is in at physiological stage when 85% or more grains are matured. After harvesting of borer paddy, it is advised the farmers to follow proper sun drying process and then after cleaning, store the grain in dry safe places. For the preparation of pre-kharif rice, we need to sow the rice in the June, July. For that, we should prepare the nursery. If we need to sow the 1 hectare crop, then we need at 800 square meter area for the growing of nursery. And we should treat the seed through the Pseudomonas fluorescence. And we should dip at the rate of 2.5 kilogram per hectare dissolved in 100 ml of water to reduce the infection of the insect and pest. Then we should follow the weed management activities later on. Then if we have farmers have standing maize crop application of split dose of nitrogen should be applied in the this summer maize. And earthing up of maize is also important to protect them from lodging during this stage. So summer maize time for earthing up to reduce the lodging of the crop. And for pre-kharif maize, we have to prepare the land for the sowing of the crop, and we should apply the FYM, and we should to go for tillage after that. Then pre-kharif season sesamum for the land, and we should apply the FYM to keep ready the soil for the sowing of the crop after getting the monsoon rain. Similarly for the moong, we should prepare of land after applying of FYM, green manure and vermicompost. Do's and don'ts for the kharif crop. So repairment of farm implements. We should keep ready our farm implements for the sowing of the kharif crop and application of manure. We should apply the FYM, green manure and vermicompost. Then land preparation and soil solarization. Before sowing of the kharif crops, we should prepare the soil, which help in the soil solarization and which this tillage operations turn the soil and which through which this heat the insect will die and there will be less infection of the disease for the crop. Then preparement of high quality seed through authentic source. We should prepare the high quality seed for the sowing, kharif sowing. Then nutrient management. We should take care of same nutrient or this soil sample from the field, and we should get the health health guard, and we according to that we should apply the nutrient. Then plant production, weed management. We should keep ready these chemicals for the plant production and weed management, then adopt a standard POP. We should adopt the standard POP for kharif crops, then planning at farm level, then we farm should keep ready for any type of mishappening. So there should be contingency plan for the farmers to face any type of situation. So like this, we can get ready, we can do ready our farm for the kharif crops. So do's and don'ts for Rajasthan farmers. So I have selected five to six states from the north, south, east and west, where the ICAR has been released the advisory for the farmers what they should follow during this COVID period. Then for the Rajasthan farmers, they harvesting of the mature crops and shifting to safer places. After harvesting, they should keep the produce to the storage and they should go for the marketing. Then drying of coriander crop after harvesting and threshing, farmers should go for the harvesting and threshing of the dry coriander. Then manual harvesting of lost crop. In somewhere the wheat crop has been lost and the harvesting is delayed, so there we can farmer can go for the manual harvesting, and there is no need for like are initiated. So we should avoid the irrigation in this situation to the garlic crop. And summer plowing in the harvested field, so we should go for the summer plowing wherever the rabi crops have been harvested. Then harvesting should be done with machine operated equipments as much as possible. We should go for the mechanical operations to reduce the labor to the field and to reduce the infection of this COVID COVID. Then cattle shed should be kept dry as far as possible. Keep goat and sheep in dry and sheds and provide green fodder, fresh and clean water 3 times in a day. Then cattle and poultry shed must be cleaned and ventilated and provide clean drinking water to them. Then do's and don'ts for Punjab farmers. Then harvesting of wheat is through combined harvesters and their movement within states and between states has been permitted. Precaution and safety measures of workers engaged in repair, maintenance and harvesting operations is to be ensured. So farmers should take care the precaution safety measures during farm operations. And post-harvest activities of wheat like threshing, storage and marketing. So farmers go for farm post-harvest activities in their respective areas. And they should go for harvesting of January sown potato also. Should harvest the potato crop and they should go for storage, transport and marketing of the potato crop in the Punjab state. Harvesting and post-harvest activities of mustard and pulses including storage and marketing. So farmers should go for the selling of their produce to the mandi in the Punjab regarding this pulses and mustard. Then deep tillage of field for soil erosion. Farmers should go for deep tillage during pre-kharif sowing season. Then field activities of jayat crops according to the stage. Farmers can go for the activities for the jayat crops whichever they have sown. Then do's and don'ts for Madhya Pradesh farmers. Harvesting and threshing of wheat, lentil, chickpea and mustard should be done. If not yet done, then farmers may start the field preparation and sowing of summer moong in irrigated areas where harvest of wheat and chickpea has been done. Then ensure availability and maintenance of farm machinery needed for field preparation and sowing of kharif crops. Then field activities for cucurbits and summer maize to be done. Then timely intercultivation operations of vegetables to be done. Then horticulture crops mainly farmers who wants to plant fruit gardens, prepare pit and keep them open for treatment, as well as select varieties of fruits, trees and arrange for planting. So these practices farmers should do for sowing of the horticultural gardens. Then intercultural operations and urea application are advised in summer vegetables like pumpkin, bitter gourd, bottle gourd and okra. So farmers must apply nutrients to good growth of pumpkin, bitter gourd and bottle gourd in their area. And do's and don'ts for the Uttar Pradesh farmers. Where wheat is lost, the farmer should go for manual harvesting. And in case of normal crop, wheat harvesting may be done with harvester. Social distance should be strictly followed and only for essential person should be allowed. Then where harvesting is over, deep plowing is advised. In case of mango, where mango orchards, infection of thrips can be controlled by application of insecticide thiomethoxamine at the rate of 0.30 gram per liter. Then powdery mildew in mango can be controlled with application of hexaconazole at the rate of 0.1 ml per liter or dry fluoroxyestrogen 0.5 gram per liter. And the farmer should follow shed drying of leafy vegetables and spices. Then stagger the field operation wherever possible and avoid engaging more numbers of person on the field. Then harvesting, grading and packaging of sweet potatoes to be done carefully, following personal safety and social distancing while doing their transportation, lodging and unloading to cold storage warehouses. Utmost care to be taken to avoid any chance of COVID-19. So while storage and transportation of the output, they should strictly follow the social distancing and hygiene so they can reduce the infection of this COVID. So while doing in cultural operations and harvesting, cleaning, etc. for seasonal vegetables and cucurbits, workers should be operation singly and staggered patches. Then summer planting of sugarcane started to the maximum possible extent, machinery to be used for the planting rather than manual planting. Likewise, full operation of summer maize, summer groundnut, hybrid palm millet and summer mung bean to be done, taking all care so that this deadly disease may not spread. So mentha is also another crop. Package and practices of mentha to be followed in this region for good crop. Do's and don'ts for Assam farmers. As the harvesting of the different field crops, vegetables, fruits are ongoing, farmers are advised to follow safety measures in the Assam state. Harvesting of field crops like lentil, linseed, mustard is done, and after harvest, proper drying is essential for good storage. Then shelf life of harvest tomato can be extended by adopting traditional method in case of delay in marketing. If farmers are not able to transport their tomato to the markets, they can increase their shelf life through ITK, through their own indigenous technical knowledge. So they can store and they can increase the shelf life of tomato, and afterwards they can use sell their produce after lift of this lockdown. Then as the cold storage services is exempted from the lockdown, potato, tomato and chili may be stored in nearest cold storage after obtaining passes with the safety measures. So this type of, they're like potato, tomato and chilies, vegetables, as we know these are perishable. We can use the cold storage for them if markets are not available. Then prefer farm level storage wherever possible for better price rather than to avoid rushing to markets immediately after harvesting to sell at prevailing lower prices. As we all know that at the time of harvest and at the time of bumper production, we generally farmers don't get the proper price and for the produce. The farmer should not be in hurry. They can store their produce and afterward, after normalization of the market, they can sell their produce and they can get the better income from the farm. Then farmers can sell their vegetables produce to identify vendors by the Department of Agriculture. So for Department of Agriculture also can help the farmers to sell their produce, and self and vehicle passes may be obtained prior to the moment of transportation. So farmers should keep in mind they should get passes before moving to the market and other places. Then FPOs may also initiate to sell the produce or obtaining proper permission from the district. So FPO, farmer produce organization, farmers to then retail shop dealing with fertilizer and seeds are allowed to operate during lockdown for lifting time window. So these fertilizers and seed shops should be open for to help the farmers. Then do's and don'ts for Tamil Nadu farmers. Then Rabi paddy is in grain filling stage in Tamil Nadu. Precautions and safety measures of workers engaged in repair, maintenance and harvesting operation laborer safety to be ensured. And groundnut and sesame crops are in majority to harvesting storage. The farmer should go there harvesting and they should store the produce and they go for the market if readily market is available, and otherwise they should store the produce. Then pulse in maturity to near harvesting stage, manual and combined harvesting is to be done following safety measures. So for the pulses, farmers should go for mechanical harvesting rather than manual harvesting. Then maize is in the cob formation stage, and measures for all armyworm management required as incident is noticed, need-based recommended control measures to be taken up. Then for sugarcane is in vegetative stage, and protective sprays and release of bioagent early should borers may be required. So we can control the disease in sugarcane with adopting these measures. Then mango in Tamil Nadu is in floating stage. Fruit drops is a major issue is noticed, which require nutrients application through foliar spray. Mixing of ingredients to be done by the following safety measures. So so for the mango, we can apply the nutrient application to supplement the nutrition to the mango crop. And banana is in vegetative stage in the Tamil Nadu, and tropical at majority stage. And citrus, cashew, papaya, turmeric, watermelon, and vegetables nearing harvest manually. Then safety precautions to be followed at every step of the harvesting, processing, storage, transport, and marketing operations. Then spiralingue, whitefly is a major problem faced by the coconut farmers in the Tamil Nadu. So farmers should contact to the KV and agricultural authorities to get the solution, and they should apply the chemical to avoid this pest. Then shortage of labor for farm operation is a critical concern, as most of the crops are nearing harvesting stage in Tamil Nadu. Farmers are getting they are facing the problem regarding labor, so they can go for the mechanical harvesting rather than manual. Then do's and don'ts for the Jharkhand farmers. In Jharkhand farmers, lentil, wheat, and gram is at harvesting stages or is almost harvested. No need to irrigate the field as there are good rain in recent past. So farmers should avoid the irrigation as Jharkhand get the good rainfall during this period. Then summer plowing is in the vacant field after harvesting of lentil. Farmers should go for summer plowing after harvesting of rabi crops. For vegetables like tomato, brinjal, chili, apply hoeing and irrigation as per requirement. For summer growing vegetables, farmers should go for hoeing, and also they should apply the nitrogen for proper growth of the vegetables. Then field operation of leafy vegetables like palak, cholai, badhua, etc. can be done for summer season. So regular field operations can be followed for these leafy vegetables. Then mealybug in mango and lychee can be controlled by the spraying of imidacloprid 17.8% SL at the rate of 1 milliliter per liter water. So this is the application to be done in mango for good fruiting. Then mite in lychee can be controlled by using ethion 50 EC at the rate of 2 ml per liter. Then powdery mildew in mango can be managed by applying recommended fungicides. So these were all about the majorly for the food grains. So now we are moving through dairy farmers. What the dairy farmers should do, they should do during this period to avoid the contamination of this coronavirus. First of all, they should follow the safety measures as in previous enterprises. So they should go for the safety measures, and they should go for animal hygiene also. They should prepare the farm level planning to fight the coronavirus if someone get infected. So the farm should be ready for this, and they reduce milk production. If farmers are not getting the milk market immediately, they should reduce the milk production through management of diet. So they can in limited quantity they should produce, and they can sell to the market. Then making of dairy by products. If market are not readily available, farmers can go for value addition products like ghee, milk powder, etc. And they can sell these items after the situation get normal. Then how to manage farm deliveries and visitors. Then how to manage the dairy farm. Farmers should create a visit log for individual who visit your farm. Farmers should keep the record for all visitors and limit the numbers of people on the farm. The farmers should reduce the labors, and they should avoid the arranging more labors during this period. An established procedure for how your farm will interact with the milk haulers. And farmers should make a procedure and how they can make selling of the produce, so they will be able to reduce the infection of this disease. An established procedure for deliveries on your farm. They should develop the standard procedure for the delivery of the farm produce, and follow and respect the safety measures implemented by supply companies. So dairy farmers should follow the such restrictions. Regarding this cleaning and disinfection, farmers should clean the shed and animal with water, and after they spray disinfection solution. So farmers should keep clean the surface of the farm with the chemical spray and like potassium permanganate, etc. So farmers should keep clean to reduce the infection of this coronavirus. While milking, farmer should milking should be do completely one time, and no milk should be retained in the mammary gland after milking. It will minimize the chance to mastitis. A farmer should go for complete milking. So this reduces the infection of mastitis to the animals. So for feeding, farmer should go for the proper feeding of the animals. They should apply the green fodder, dry fodder, and concentrated food to the animals for the proper dieting. They should follow the proper diet to get the maximum benefit, and they go for the proper vaccination as per the schedule to the animals. And do's and don'ts for the poultry farm. Poultry farmers should frequently clean and sanitize objects and surfaces, and they are tested regularly by the working staff. So the cleanliness and hygiene is important. Soap, water, and hand sanitizer to be kept at the entrance of the poultry farm. And washing of hands with soap should be carried out at regular intervals. Then poultry farmers, workers should use mask while working in the poultry farm. Then any worker who is unwell should not come to the poultry farm, and he should be on leave. Then proper hygiene to be maintained in the poultry shed, and disinfection of sheds be carried out at a regular intervals. The farmer should farmer should go for the regular cleaning of the surface at the of the farm. Then maintain a distance of 3-4 feet by workers and staff during rest. They should maintain the social distance. Then personnel other than the poultry house workers should be restricted inside the poultry. Farmers should restricted the outsiders to enter in the farm poultry to reduce the infection of this COVID. Then other guidelines: feeders, waters, filter, and filler plates, feed measuring scoops be sanitized, and different species of birds and different age group of birds should be kept separately. Then any kind of stress to the bird should be avoided. Then footpath with a suitable disinfection solution. The farmer should go for the disinfection. Regarding feeding, farmer should go for their regular feeding. And for vaccination, the farmer should follow their chart for the vaccination. And the collection of eggs, they should store through hygienically, and fumigation of eggs should be done to reduce the infection of the chance of this COVID. And for fisheries enterprises, the fisheries enterprise should follow the board. They should do the hygienic of board, then equipment cleaning and sanitization. They should go for pest control. They should adopt safety and water and ice. They should regularly change the water and ice. They should not use the previous ice, and they should contamination. They should reduce the cross contamination in the fish ponds. Then clean the net, gear, accessories, and equipment thoroughly using clean water. So farmer should change the clean. They should use the clean water for the washing of the equipment. Then use of hygienic fish containers as a fish pond hold. So for the containing the fishes, they should use the this hygiene containers. Then transport of fish product to a clean truck should be performed quickly. So for the transportation of the fishes, the container should be clean, and the sanitization of the truck should be done to reduce the contamination of this. So restrict the timing of sale. The timing of the sale of the fisheries product should be reduced, and seek medical care. If there is any medical type of problem, they should consult with the medical person, people to reduce the infection. And restrict the entry. They should restrict the entry of the people. Then maintain the water quality and give proper nutrition to the fisheries. So these are the practices to be followed by the fisheries farmers to get the best benefits from the fisheries. So these are the do's and don'ts for horticultural crops. Farmer should prepare for the nursery for the vegetable crops, and according to standards, package, and practices, they should prepare the nursery, and they should go for the transplanting, and they should go for the nutrient application of the farmers. They can follow the SOPs for according to their state and according to the local climate. Then after farmers has to be done so many things to reduce the impact of coronavirus, but after that the government has to do many activities to ensure the income of the farmers. Here some activities are mentioned by the government that should be followed by implicated through the government. The government has correctly issued lockdown guidelines that exempt farm operations and supply chains, but implementation problems leading to labor shortage and falling prices should be rectified. Government has already announced the and they have exempted the agricultural activities through this lockdown, but the farmers are facing the labor shortage and falling prices, and they are not getting the proper mandis are also closed nowadays. The government should ensure this providing labor and these proper prices of the farmers' output. So government should take the initiative in this way to ensure the income of the farmer. And keeping supply chain functional well is crucial to food security. So supply chain should be kept continue as we to proper supply of the feed. It should be noted that 2 to 3 billion deaths in the Bengal famine of 1943 were due to food supply disruption. So in 1943, there are so many deaths due to disruption in the supply of the food. So in this COVID situation, government should ensure the supply chain function of the vegetables, food, oils, and etc. So farmers should, the government should do and take this initiative to ensure the food supply chain of the food grains. Then farmer population must be protected from the coronavirus to be extended possible by testing and practices social distancing. Farmers should go for should give the special emphasis on the farmers and which are engaged in the farming activities, and they should go for practical social they should go for testing of them, and they should issue some guidelines, and they should do in this field for the farmers. Farmers must have continued access to markets. This can be a mix of private markets and government procurements. Government should arrange the more opportunities to the farmers to sell their produce in the mandi during this alarming situation, and government should try to ensure the income of the farmers. Then ISPAL poultry and dairy farms need more targeted help as their pandemic related input supply and market access problems are urgent. So there are dairy and poultry farmers more sensitive for this pandemic situation. Our government should initiate government should take major initiatives to help this farmers of the regarding this poultry and dairy, because the infection chance is more in this this section, and farmers should get the benefit. So that's why government should do the they should implicate the more planning for the this type of farmers. Then farmers and agricultural workers should be included in the government's assistance package. Government should include the, most of the farmers in the assistance package, and this should ensure the social protection programs addressing the crisis. So this activity should be done by the government for the farmers. As lockdown measures have increased, demand has risen for home delivery. Government should provide such a platform, and through that the farmers can sell their produce through e-commerce. And helpful in the future also, and through this process the farmer can get the direct benefit, and they can get the mediators, and through that farmer will get the maximum benefit. The farmer should, as a government, should create such environment, and they should facilitators for the farmers. Then government should promote trade by avoiding export bans and import restrictions. Wherever possible, the government should allowing the export of the agricultural commodities, and restrictions should be lifted out as soon as possible, and wherever it is possible, so that farmer can get the benefits. Below are some additional measures needed in addition to the government package. Apart from these activities, farmer the government can food and supply nutrient security through ICDs. Government should plan this integrated child development program. Through this, more of the grains and farm output can be used in this ICT plants, midday meals, Anganwadis. So government should active these organizations, and they should promote them to use the farmers' input. Then cash transfer, government should take some initiative to transfer some amount of in form of cash to the help of the farmers. Then migrant workers, cash and nutrient security. Farmer government should reduce the migrant of workers through providing cash and nutrient security to them. So thank you. I would like to thanks to Dr. P. Chandrasekhar, Director General NIAM, for providing such a platform for the webinar, and Mr. Abhishek Sharma, who helped throughout this period, and he assisted us about the presentation. Then faculty and staff of NIAM, Director of ICR and BSS LUP, Dr. S.S. Rao, Principal Scientist and Head of ICR and BSS LUP Udaipur, then staff members and colleagues of ICR and BSS LUP, then national facilitators and participants. I again want to thank you all, and thanks for a valuable thinking. So, So this is about the four further inquiry details are there. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Well, entire presentation. Now I request the participants to please raise your questions. Participants can switch on their mics and ask the question. Participant can also write the question in chat box.